You're welcome to the daily broadcast of the prophetic word. I'm Pastor Mark Akiti, your regular host. I believe God that today, Friday, the 20th of August, that God Almighty will visit you and I in a very special way in Jesus' name. Let's have a word of prayer. Oh Lord, our God, we thank you for today, for all your goodness in our lives in the name of Jesus. Thank you for waking us up. Thank you for a brand new day in Jesus' name. Father, we ask, oh God, for a fresh breath of the Holy Spirit upon every area of our lives. Lord, breathe upon us. Breathe upon every fiber of our being. Breathe upon everything that concerns us. Let fresh life come upon us. Come upon our activities. Come upon everything we do. Let the Holy Spirit take over all that concerns us in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Today I'm going to be discussing what I titled Destroying the Destroyer. Destroying the Destroyer. In John chapter 10 and verse 10, the Bible says the thief cometh not but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But I am come that they might have life and have it more abundantly. Two persons were mentioned there. The devil who comes as a thief to steal, to destroy, to steal, to kill, and to destroy the good things that God has planned for you. And there's Jesus who came to counter the works of the devil. And Jesus said, I am come that they might have life. Life. And have it more abundantly. God wants to give you abundant life, abundant health, abundant victory, abundant prosperity, abundant promotion, abundance on every side. So if there's any form of negativity and things are going wrong in any area of your life, just know it is not God that is working those things. Those are the handwork of the evil one. Those are the handwriting, the handwork of the devil. That is the devil. There's destruction in any area of your life. That is the devil at work. If there's sickness in your life, that is the devil at work. Poverty in your life, that is the devil at work. If there is barrenness in your life, that is the devil at work. If any form of sickness is the work of the devil. Retardation is the work of the devil. Retrogression is the work of the devil. Hit and promise and fail is the work of the devil. Anything that is negative, it is the work of the devil. Jesus came to destroy. 1 John chapter 3 verse 8, the Bible says, for this purpose the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the work of the devil. John 10 verse 10 says the devil is a destroyer. And 1 John 3 verse 8 says Jesus Christ came to destroy the works of the destroyer. Jesus Christ came to destroy the works of the devil. Whatever is a work, an assignment of the devil in your life, by the power of the Holy Spirit, God will destroy them. God will uproot them out of your pathway. It may be a sickness in your body. Today, the power of God is going to locate you, and healing is coming to destroy those works of the devil in your life. The Bible says how God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Acts chapter 10 verse 38, that's what Jesus came to do, to destroy the works of the devil, to put an end to every operation of the devil in your life. Whatever is the seed of the wicked one in your body today, God will destroy it. Whatever is the operation of the devil in your finances today, God will destroy it. Peradventure, as you are listening to me right now, there are things that the devil has stolen from your life. He has stolen your opportunities. He has stolen your blessings. He has stolen your helpers. He has stolen good things from your life. Today, the power of God will restore to you all that the devil stole from your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, he will restore. The Bible says when the thief is caught, he will restore sevenfold. Satan is that thief. And the Bible has described him as a thief. The throne of God has caught him, and he must refund. He will restore to you what is stolen from your body. He will restore to you what is stolen from your finances. The things he stole from your finances through wickedness, through sin, through sickness that he planted in your body, he will restore. From today, your money will not be used to service sicknesses anymore, because God is reversing the irreversible. Jesus Christ is destroying every work of the destroyer in your life, in Jesus' name. Right where you are, the power of the living God is coming upon you. Right where you are, it's coming upon you right now. Right now, right now. Receive it, receive it, receive it, receive it. I pray for you right now, in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, let the anointing of the Holy Spirit descend upon this person right now. Descend upon this my listener right now. In the name of Jesus. Anything the devil has planted in this body to destroy, I command such plantation to be destroyed right now, uprooted in Jesus' name. Every sickness, every disease that is in your body, whatever is eating up, I see eating up, whatever is eating up your body, I don't know, whatever is eating up, that's what I'm hearing, whatever is eating up your body, in the mighty name of Jesus, I curse it to die in Jesus' name. I curse that thing to die in Jesus' name. I cause this cancerous growth. I cause this cancerous growth in the name of Jesus. Die. Die, you this growth. Die and dry up in the name of Jesus. I uproot every disease in your body. Disease in your body organs. I uproot them right now. In the name of Jesus. There's a woman listening to me right now. I curse that root of barrenness. It's not from God. It's the work of the devil. Jesus came to destroy it. I curse that root of barrenness. In Jesus' name, I command that womb right now, become fruitful. In the name of Jesus, whatever the devil has stolen from your business, whatever the devil has programmed into your business that have been making you to be incurring losses upon losses in your business, that devil is a liar. I curse those losses right now. I curse the source and the root of those losses right now. And I declare that chapter of business failure and losses closed in Jesus' name. I declare open the door of progress, the door of progress in that business, in the work of your hands, in the name of Jesus. I hear in the spirit a lady saying, when will you mention my own case? In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray by the power of the Holy Ghost that the anointing of God will locate you right now. In Jesus' name, any covering that the enemy placed upon your life to hinder your helpers from seeing you, I destroy those covering right now. In Jesus' name, as the lady listen to me, I command your beauty to appear. I command your beauty to appear to your suitor right now. I command your beauty to appear to your suitor right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Akubilanda kapa parakaya karamusata lekronosko paramahachwa. I declare marital breakthrough right now. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. We appreciate you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. If you have not given your life to Jesus Christ, I want you to say after me, Lord Jesus, I come to you today in the name of Jesus. Have mercy on me and forgive me all my sins. Wash my sins away in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for saving me in Jesus' name. If you have said that, you have made a confession, you are born again, and it is well with you, we'll keep praying for you. In the main name of Jesus, you surely testify on this platform in Jesus' name. You can also reach us on this telephone line, +234 8058 000 442. Or you can send us an email, godanswersbyfire@gmail.com. Hallelujah. God bless you. Just like we discussed some time ago, our partner suggested that we need to move this work forward, that we should at least be taking an offering, at least a seed, at least once a week on every Friday. I prayed about it until I got a conviction to do so. Bear in mind that this prophetic word is the broadcast of the Spirit Flame Ministries. Spirit Flame Ministries is an apostolic mandate for prayers and revival. We are going somewhere. God is taking you to heights that is beyond human comprehension, and we will all testify. So for those who would like to connect with me in giving and receiving, after the order of Philippians chapter 4, verse 15, that Apostle Paul taught us, I will give you an account detail. It's a Guarantee Trust Bank, GT Bank, 011-5099-569. Guarantee Trust Bank. Account name is Mark Akiti, MARKAKITI. You can copy that number out on the paper, and when you so you see it, you can save it in your phone, so next time it's easy to retrieve it. It's principally for those who are motivated to do so. If you are motivated to connect to me in giving and receiving, you are free to do so. But if you are not motivated to sow a seed, don't even bother about it. Don't let it worry you. Do not affect my praying for you. I will still continue to pray for you. It does not affect the answer to your prayers. God will answer your prayers, answer my prayers. We are pushing on together on this platform. On higher ground we are going in the name of Jesus. No power will stop me. No power will stop you. We will testify. Your testimony is guaranteed in Jesus' name. Let me still give you another word of encouragement. Before I hang up, remember to share this message with somebody. It is not just a message you are sharing. There's the blessings of God you are distributing. What is the works of the devil in their lives that you are destroying as you push this message to them? Don't keep it to yourself. Push it out. Distribute it to everybody in your group and in your contact. And as God is blessing them, God also will bless you in return in the name of Jesus. The Bible says God gave the word, and great is the company of those who publish it. As you join in publishing it, you'll be shocked what God is going to do in your life. Until I see you again tomorrow morning, I leave you once again with this word. Don't settle for less. There's more to come. Shalom.